YouTube, this is Farmall 51 here. I'm going to do a video here on my 1961 Farmall 504. I'm going to explain a few of the kind of special features about this tractor. This here is kind of a unique tractor. It being the serial number on it being the most unique thing of all here. I know you probably don't see many this low. Has serial number 520 with the prefix S and a Y, and I'll put a little sidebar here showing that later, what that means later here. This is here is a 1961 Farmall 504, serial number 520, and most of you know International started out with this, on their serial numbers with 501. So this being 520, this makes this the 20th tractor made. Correct me if I'm wrong here, I think it's the 20th tractor, I think that's right. It has a C123 engine, four cylinder engine. Everything's original on this tractor, so. And another thing here, well, before I get to that, it's a tricycle row crop tractor. The other unique thing about this tractor here is the side panels. I'll put a picture up of a later tractor, or of the other 504 with the different side panels. But this one here has a smaller side panels on it. Most of you have probably seen one with the larger side panels. I don't believe they made this very long with the short side panels like this. If you notice, if I stand to the side here, there's a big gap between the radiator and the front of the engine block. I'm thinking it was somewhere around 62 that they took, and they made the larger side panel, and it came out to about right here and went straight down, and it covered up this hole that you see. Now the other thing, this tractor has the same rear end that a early 656 has on it. Let's see else. I've read that they had the same, and I imagine it's the same frame rails up here also, because that would explain the gap. And if you were to get a six-cylinder engine, that would fit in there just about right. So, which I wouldn't mind doing that later on, but. Not this tractor, but if I had me another 504, get me a engine out of a 656 and put in here. But that explains the side panels and the serial number. But I bought this tractor from Acock Tractor in Goldsboro. I think I'm about the third owner of this tractor. I talked to the original, one of the original owners, and he explained to me all what he did with it. They never used it all that much. He had the engine overhauled in it not too long before he sold it. It has a Zenith carburetor and a probably AC Delco alternator. And this tractor here came with, I don't know if you can see that or not, but came with a generator originally. But somebody, I guess, you know how the generators go. They usually go bad if they're not taken care of or kept up. But they put an alternator on here, which is, it works. It charges the battery. I never have any problem with it. It starts right up. But I'll start it here in a little bit. But I know if you can see right here, there's an extension between the water pump and the fan blade. They had to do that so they could have the fan blade up there right next to the radiator to pull the air through good, have good airflow. So, and then that probably helped too when they extended the side panels out to close that gap. But this tractor here is equipped with the mid-mount hydraulic hookups here. It has two on the other side also in the same position. They used... I know they use this tractor a lot for, or this type of 504 here for cotton pickers. I've seen a mini one with cotton picker attachment on it, but also yeah. It'll be used for the loader, a loader attachment on this tractor, which a tricycle wouldn't be too good of an idea, but people had, you know, people use them. So this tractor here is equipped with the torque amplifier, or TA, and it has been rebuilt. So this tractor here, I've pulled it before. I've been pulling a disc, and I never actually had to use it, but I've pulled it just to be pulling it. But it does work. I know these type of clutches in here, you can't hold it for very long, or you're not supposed to. It's not recommended to hold it in TA for a long amount of time. So there, I think there has a dry clutch in it, but the only thing you're wrong with this TA here is this little bracket right here. If you can see, somebody has put a little bead of weld on here. That little tab is broken off, and it has rounded off up here. You can pull it back, but you have to hold it with your hand the entire time to keep it in the higher range, so, or the lower range, excuse me. It's in high range now, so, but you do have to hold it, and sometimes it will stay and sometimes it won't, but if you hit a bump with the tire, it'll pop right out. So I'm looking for that piece, that particular piece right there, if anybody happens to know where one is, and possibly this little hook bracket right here, I guess, or a little piece right here. I might as well get it also, since it's rounded off and it probably won't never hold if I change out the other piece. But it works really good. Never had no trouble with it. It doesn't slip, and I've had it under hard load before. And this tractor does have the live PTO on it. Or the, not live PTO, but the independent PTO. But you can push in the clutch, you can stop the tractor without the PTO, having to disengage the PTO. The way you do that is the lever right here. You just pull it up to shut it off, or push it down to shut it off, vice versa. But that is the wrong drawbar on this tractor. Somebody put a John Deere, and that's why you see it's leaking. But I got a seal back there leaking on that PTO I got to fix. But other than that, then that style of seat that came on it, I don't know if that's a seat that somebody had put on here, but that's not the seat that's supposed to be on these tractors. I'll put a picture of that. What seat's supposed to be on this tractor anyway? But the everything underneath here is what's supposed to be on there. But, and it'll slide forward or back. So and I got to get a new steering wheel for it. But a few of the gauges I got to replace. And you can see it has very straight sheet metal. I don't see any dents anywhere. And about right here, I can't make out, it's got the dealer's tag on it, but somebody I think has painted it with a paintbrush. But, and you can barely make out, you can see parts and service, but I can't make out the dealer's name. You can barely see the IH logo right there, but has all the emblems on it. It's very rare. They're pretty expensive, I think, on OEM or Farmall Parts.com or Steiner's or Restoration Supply, and any of those I know y'all get parts from. They're pretty expensive. It's got the disc brakes on it. And the tires here are in pretty good shape. You can still never see the size road on it. Here's the 13.638. And I've got the 420 plow hooked up to it. We took it to the show a couple weeks ago. But I'm gonna go ahead and start it up and let you hear it run. And I've got a muffler for it, but I've got it on another tractor I was using. always shut the gas off, because I come in here one time on the M there, and I didn't shut the gas off like I should have, and it ran 4 or 5 gallons of gas. I come back in the shop the next morning, and the vapors about knocked me down. Luckily, I didn't have anything running in here that had a pilot light or anything like that on. It would have been in pretty bad shape, and the wiring on here is kind of bad. It looks to me like it's original wiring, but it's been patched and stuff like that, and I'm not too sure, but I'd love to get a wiring harness to put on here, but our club keychain, chapter 37. Let's see here. I know it's supposed to have the push start and all this on it, but somebody has put the regular key start on it. I'll probably switch that out later on. I know Ron on Vidman 008, he doesn't like the push start, so, and I guess, you know, you got a preference. It's good when it works, but like Ron said, it's a pain in the butt, and you might as well change it out if you ever get a chance, but... or if it ever starts giving trouble, you might as well switch it out and go the other way. But all right, we'll go ahead and start it up here. Well, that's the 1961 Farmall 504, serial number 520. And if you have any questions about it, or any other videos, you know, you want to see me do something with the tractors or something like that, or you want to see them work, or another video done of them, or walk around video, or, you know, things like that, but just let me know, and I'll see if I can get to that sooner or later. Busy grass cutting now, so I don't have much time to. And the garden's about done with having to do any tractor work, so. But all right, well, talk to you later. All right, bye. They all tried to tell me, but I guess I didn't care.